Hello, children of God. Welcome back to Marie Speaks God's Grace Bible Study. Today, after I was in prayer, I was given a word from the Lord. And I believe that the Lord our God is showing us, telling us, giving us confirmation to many of our prayers, many of our praising and raising, the roaring that has been going on in the spirit. So I'm gonna get in to the Rhema word, and then we can discuss, or I'll review what I saw. Thus says the Lord, just as apparel rewind the twin towers, flights, towers, power surge, experiences, swollen, purged, negative, unholy experiences. Holy is my name, Yah. Resemble janks, resemble white walls for peace, assemble white clothes for the performing class work. Tremble at his voice, Jesus Christ calls. Listen, those who hear. Hear to the voice and listen to the voice of his chosen one, Jesus, who saves. Search out for the outlying forces behind the black velvet cloaks. Satanic temples down. They will crumble. They will tremble. They shall tremble and crumble down. Sparkles of joy, wonderful joy, glory of joy, destroying satanic temples, easily replaced. God of grace and the grace of God employs many of his servants to do his will. Serve, Yah, servants. Go to the mountaintops, shout the praise of Yah for all he has done. Beyond time, Yah ensures holy pleasures are godly pleasures. Yah makes all complete. Completeness for his service in Yah. Service company. Compile your service agencies. The agendas of Yah are pure love, pure truth, and pure goodness. I am the Lord your God. I do not serve lesser gods. God Almighty serves none, and no other shall you serve. Rise, Ruth. Rise, Deborah, arise, Israel, and arise, Jacob. Answer the call, Samuel. Speak, anointed ones. Speak, told the words of Yah. I am the Lord God, worthy of all praise. Words, not compliance. Suggestions, not laws. Ordinances, not legal. With all corruption shall form a wall and perish in the watery grave. Like pigs, you swine, dwell and travel abroad, aboard vessels of sin. Vessels green, child poor, children bodies. I pity my little ones. Settle my poor. Unions, rebuild and divide the country. Poor children. He, meaning Jesus Christ our Lord, he wipes the tears formed on their cheeks. Hallelujah. My hand, Jesus speaks, my hand wipes the very tears off the cheeks of all the children who cry for the Savior. From the darkest darkness, while choirs of angels sing praise for all the captives being set free. Hallelujah. A downpour of refreshing rain. Downpour of refreshing showers rushes and washes sins away, revealing paths evil takes, like path tunnels will collapse. On their head, of the very hands of who dug the tunnels and tugged on the ropes of the chains of the slave. The slave conferences. Surely evil conferences are not hidden from me, says the Lord of hosts. I shall trample all altars of Satan on the whole earth with one word, I am the Lord. Amen. So while I was in praise, what I saw from our Father in heaven, when I was being given this word, was a confirmation of a previous word our Father in heaven gave to us, where our Father God showed us how the destruction of the satanic temples has and will be taking place. A lot of these erected temples that are throughout the United States and throughout the world, these phallic symbols, these Baal demonic symbols, which we rebuke in Yeshua's great name, these idol churches, hallelujah, they are going to literally collapse at the word of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. And many are going to call it because of an earthquake. Many are going to be call it, I don't know, because of a solar flare. They're going to say it's some freak accident of quote unquote Mother Nature. But do not be fooled, children of the Most High, ever loving, living God. This destruction of all these satanic temples that are crumbling and will crumble and have crumbled are being done by the hand of God with the authority of Jesus Christ and by the power of his beautiful, pure, and Holy Ghost. Amen. Another word that our Father in heaven gave me when I was given this word was Kundalini, which many of us know means coil, and it's a false holy spirit. It is the spirit of the serpent. It is the Antichrist spirit. It is the spirit of Leviathan, which we rebuke in Yeshua's great name. Now, this Kundalini spirit can take up several different forms, and what our Father and God is showing me is it's serpent-like dancing. Now, before John the Baptist's head was decapitated, the daughter of his incestuous relationship with his sister wife or his brother's wife, the emperor at that time, the daughter danced pleasingly to his eye. This was satanic serpent Kundalini dances. Strippers do this dance. Pole dancers do this dance. That yoga dancing do this dance. Do not engage in those type of dances, children of God. That is all under the false holy spirit of the Kundalini spirit, which we were rebuking Yeshua's great name. So what God was showing me is through these beautiful awes and wonders that our Father in heaven is going to have take place is many are going to claim that it is Mother Nature. They are going to claim that it is a false Holy Spirit, Mother Nature. But us as children of God need to ensure we are being like Samuel when we wake up. Let us say, speak, Lord, for your servant is listening. When we feel a vibration of the Holy Ghost, amen. Let us say, speak, Lord, for your servant is listening. When we feel the inspiration to praise, praise God. When we feel the inspiration to pray wherever we are, whatever we are doing, whatever we may be engaged in, we need to pray. This prayer time, this season, hallelujah, is powerfully anointed by the Lord our God. Now, you can be a praying prophet. You can be a praying saint of the Lord. You could be a praying healer, a praying seer, wherever you are in the body of Christ. The point is pray. If you are a praise and worship leader, pray. If you are an artist of the Lord, pray. If you are an auto mechanic and auto service of the Lord, pray. As you wield your tools, you welders of God, hallelujah, you casting that iron, you blowing that glass, you rattling those windows, hallelujah, pray, thus says the Lord, amen. Our prayers collected, even in the spirit, miles and continents away, is lifted up as a beautiful, holy gold flakes up to the very ears of the Lord our God. Amen. If you are a new believer in the body of Christ, angels are shouting and rejoicing over you. Pray over you coming to being saved and having eternal life with our Savior and all of us in the body of Christ. Pray. If you don't think you know how to pray, pray, talk, have a conversation with God. Talk with God about where you are going, what you are doing, how to get there, what you should buy, where you should buy it, and how it should be gifted onto someone. Pray. Amen. I truly feel that God is outlining several prophecies that have been spoken by his servants of the events regarding the towers, the twin towers, everything being disclosed and uncovered. Amen. There are many agencies that are going to be trampled and tumble underfoot. Amen. God's anointed are going to increase in their anointing. Your skin even maybe feel more oily, even the scalp of your hair, even the soles of your feet are going to feel more oily, even the palms of your hands. You are going to notice wherever you go, hallelujah, I feel the Lord so strongly on this, praise God. Just your very presence there is going to produce healing, is going to produce the legal system going into those places. Just your very presence being led by our Father who is in heaven is going to ensure more souls come to Christ. The Lord our God sent me on a mission yesterday, and I felt really inspired to go to three or four separate locations, but under the same category of locations. Now, these were locations that I normally don't tend to go to. I'm just going to be quite honest. They are locations that prior to loving the Lord more correctly and truly following God more honestly, purely, and goodly, that I used to quite frequent. And I felt inspired to go to these places. And initially, what I thought I was going for and what my service was going to be there and how I would perform these services, in my mind, did not end up happening at all. But I felt the leading of the Lord to stay, and when he said to move to another place, I moved to another place and I went. And then I came home, and as I was driving, I said, God, Did I hear you wrong, Lord? Did I fail? Was I not supposed to be there? I didn't end up doing anything I thought I would do. I didn't sing the songs that were praise and worship songs. I didn't hand out my leaflets. I didn't even hand out a Bible. I ended my prayer that evening, yesterday evening, telling God, I'm sorry if I failed you. I'm sorry if I heard you wrong. I'm sorry if I went somewhere I shouldn't have gone. Maybe I was fantasizing and leading myself astray. Father, forgive me. And I went to sleep. And it is not very often where I will sleep through the night. But I slept through the night last night. And I, in that place between waking and dreaming, God showed me personally several things. But at the very end of that, hallelujah, glory be to the living God, God explained to me so lovingly and compassionately why I was sent there to those places. And he told me, Marie, you didn't fail. Your expectation and your idea of what you were going to do or what was going to take place wasn't what I needed to let happen or to have happen, right? And I said, oh, Father God, what you had happened was so much better than anything I could have ever thought of. See, God was showing me by merely going to a place and sitting there. His Holy Ghost was going into those places, and everyone who spoke to me, His Holy Ghost, hallelujah, was going to move them to come to Christ. And God reminded me of His verse that no one comes to the Son except by the Father's leading. And I said, yes, Lord. Sing your praises all the day long. I love you. You are so wise and glorious and wondrous, Lord. Your ways are not my ways, Lord. Your thoughts are not my thoughts. And I am so very grateful, Lord. Thank you for humbling me. Thank you for putting me in my place so lovingly. And thank you for sending me out in places that I would honestly not normally go, and speaking to persons I might not have normally ran into, just so I could give them your word and your presence, because they were so very needing it, including me. Last night was an appointed time and place, and it was confirmed through a vision in the natural of the supernatural. God showed me in a vision with someone else's presence that I was exactly where I was supposed to be, doing exactly what God ordered me to do, in a place I would not normally go. Now, I share this because I feel God wants me to share this, because God might send His servant somewhere where they might not normally go to speak to persons they might not normally speak to, in a location where they most likely have not been before. Now, always confirm with God. Always pray, always ensure that you are following God's Holy Ghost. And if you are like me and ever begin to doubt yourself, not doubt God, but doubt yourself, maybe that you heard wrong. Maybe you think like me that you were leaning on your own understanding. When God says no, I sent you there, He will confirm with a word for us. He will confirm with us with a vision, a dream, a leaning, a wonder, or a sign. Give praise to God In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Let us pray. Father God, in the blessed name of our Yeshua HaMashiach, our Lord, our Christ, Emmanuel, for God is forever and always with us. Thank you for this beautiful word. Thank you for leading and guiding us, Lord. Thank you for sending us to places where we are supposed to go to do things we are supposed to do for the body of Christ by order of the only living God. Father, we praise your blessed name, for you are worthy, wondrous, and glorious. All glory be to the only living God and his only begotten Son, our Jesus Christ of Nazareth, and your beautiful, powerful Holy Ghost. Blessed be the name of the Lord, who changes hearts and minds, refines us in the fire, presses us down, turning us into diamonds, where you will see your own reflection in us, and so will others. Thank you, God, for using us for your service. Thank you for calling up more servants of the Lord. Thank you for increasing our anointment. Thank you for increasing our appointments. And thank you for healing, hallelujah, every spiritual and natural wound in our mind, our body, our spirit, and our soul. Thank you for giving us hearts of flesh and removing, hallelujah, every heart of stone. In Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior's beautiful name, we pray, filled with the Holy Spirit, the Ruach HaKadosh, and sealed with the blood of Christ. Amen. All right, children of the Most High, ever-loving, living God, I am going to get going. I pray others truly got something out of this word from our Father who is in heaven. I pray that others feel the leading from God's Holy Spirit and they go out and seek his voice and seek his face. And please, children of God, remember, always confirm and pray to the Lord our God. Amen. Amen. So till next time, children of the Most High, ever-loving, living God, may God bless you, may God keep you, may we all be forever written in the book of life. Amen.